Okay. A very good evening. The red light is on. Good evening and welcome to the KLFA Stadium ahead of the 2019 AFC Cup Final between DPR Korea's 425 and Lebanon's Al Ahed. It's going to be a very interesting night indeed. History in the making. We will talk about that in just a bit. But first, my name is Reem Shahwa, and joining me in this preview show is none other than Warriors FC former midfielder Roshan Rai. So Roshan, I was saying about how tonight is very historic because, of course, first time finalists for both teams. It's the first time as well that a DPR Korea team is facing a Lebanon side in the AFC Cup. Also, you know, where we're standing right now in Malaysia. Yep. First time AFC Cup final happening here.
Listen, it's a very exciting, occasion. And the stadium as well. I just came here yesterday. It was the first time I've been to Kuala Lumpur Stadium. And it's just really suited to the occasion. You know, it's nice and compact. It's close to the pitch, even with the running track here.
Yeah.
You just feel like you get a little bit of atmosphere. Get the players in there, have a closer look at how they'll be doing in this game. So yeah, I'm looking forward to this. And a little bit of, as you say, history in the making.
Yeah.
The first title potentially for Al Ahed or 425, and not just for the clubs, but for their respective nations as well.
But of course, very surprising news. We just got the team sheets, and the star player for 425, Kim Yoo-sung, is not starting. Are we surprised?
Yeah, that is a big surprise to the starting lineup. From the team sheets that we've received, he is not going to be in the starting 11 for 425. He is a top scorer this season with 9 goals in the AFC Cup. I spoke to Oh Yoon-sun yesterday, and he did mention that they had an injured player. They had an issue with an injury. He didn't quite say who it was.
Right.
He said it was an important player, and we found out now that it is going to be Kim Yoo-sung. Mm-hmm. Aside from that, they've made another 2 changes. Anil Bom comes in to replace Kim Yoo-sung, and you know, last year in the AFC Cup in 2018, he was their top scorer with 12 goals.
Right.
But this year, this campaign hasn't been the best for him in terms of that goal scoring, but he's got plenty of experience, and in terms of that profile of player, he'll give them something different than Kim Yoo-sung. Rim Chol-min will be starting up front for them, the captain as well. So that front too, you can expect a little bit more mobility from Anil Bom, perhaps not playing as necessarily that 2 up front, 2 target men up front, but you expect Anil Bom to just be moving across the forward line and looking to try and get in behind the opposition defence perhaps. And if I just touch on very quickly those other 2 changes made to the lineup, Park Song-rok comes in and Cho Chul-soo as well. This is from the last game against Hanoi that was a 0-0 draw.
Okay, if you were part of the defensive lineup for Al Ahed, how much of a relief though is to not see Yoo-sung on the starting lineup?
I mean, they would have prepared for him. So, there perhaps will be a need for some adjustments to be made there as well. The coach, Basim Amar, has got to have a look at the lineup and see, we're dealing with perhaps a different tactic, maybe a different style of player.
Yeah.
And it's something that they will have to adjust to as well. But look, Al Ahed defensively, they will be pretty confident, having only conceded those 3 goals in 10 matches in this campaign so far. It's been absolutely fantastic. 8 clean sheets. This is a side that has built their campaign on that foundation of being very defensively solid.
Yeah. Let's, rewind a little bit, look at the journey for both sides. But I guess we can't talk about that without mentioning how close each side got. It's in the competition last year. I think 425 made it into the interzonal finals, whereas Al Ahed made it into the West Asia semis. How much do you think the squad has progressed since then, and how have they strengthened in which areas?
I was speaking to the coaches yesterday as well, and I think one of the things that they both touched on with their respective sides is the fact that they feel that both their teams are now quite stable. They don't have to, you know, make too many changes in transfer windows. They don't have to bring in three or four players, perhaps for Al Ahed, for example. The coach Bassem was telling me that, you know, they just maybe needed to bring in one or two more players just to complement the side, just to pad it up a little bit, because they've had that stability and that structure for a while now. These are two teams, as you mentioned, with lots of pedigree in this competition, and there are international level players on both these sides. You know, you've got recently a former Lebanon international, Hetem Faour, who was at the Asian Cup. You've got their goalkeeper, Mehdi Khalil, who has been a rock for them in goal, keeping shots out, keeping all those clean sheets. And then in front of him, you have the likes of Nour Mansour as well, again, a Lebanese international central defender. So there's plenty of quality in this Al Ahed side, lots of experience in there. And the same can be said for 425, you know, having grown together, gaining those experiences. They came close last year to making it through. And Oh Yoon Son has actually tried to, I think, maybe perhaps take a little bit of the pressure off his players by saying that their aim this season was to just win the interzonal final. So that's done and dusted. This AFC Cup final is a bonus for them. But don't believe for a second that his players are just going to accept that, because Rim Cholmin has told me that, you know, it's not just enough to be in the final. They want to go out there and win it and be standing on that podium and lifting a trophy.
All right, then, touching on 425 and their journey so far, 24 goals, I think, in total up to this point. Obviously, a very, you know, big attacking threat. Talk us through, you know, from the knockout stages, before that, the group stages as well.
Yeah, they were in the east zone of this competition. They were up against Kichi, Taipo and Hang Yuen, and they breezed through it quite comfortably, you know, scoring those 17 goals, conceding just two. By the time they lost one game in the group stages, they were already qualified for the next stages. And then it was a big challenge in the interzonal semi-finals, coming up against Abahani in there. Over two legs, you know, there were goals, you know, 4-3, Abahani won the first leg at home. And then 425 at home, where they've been unbeaten for a while now. They've been very strong there. Picked up a 2-0 win in the second leg to go through into the interzonal finals, where they came up against a very good Hanoi side. 2-2 in the first leg, and those two away goals were so important for 425. They went back home. They were able to shut out Hanoi 0-0. They went through on the away goals, and, you know, Rim Cholmin said that, you know, he respects Hanoi FC. He says that they were a very good team, but he feels that just their mentality is something that has taken them through into the final, and he will need that mentality from his side tonight, that fighting spirit that they've shown, that they've displayed. But they've also got quality here. I mean, we know they can score goals. It's not just about being compact. You know, we know that they've got quick combinations down the flanks. I like Hyok Chol in central midfield, stringing things together, stringing passes together for them. Son Fyong Il, down the left-hand side, down on the flanks, looking to take defenders on, create opportunities. And of course, Rim Cholmin up front, looking to finish off those chances.
Mm-hmm. And on the flip side for Al Ahed, you know, they've been super, they're like the wall, right, in this competition. You call them the wall, because only three goals conceded, like you mentioned, eight clean sheets. What's the story there?
Yeah, look, that's their foundation in this AFC Cup campaign. Defensively, they have been solid. Spoke to Bassem, the coach, and he says, you know, we've conceded just three goals, we've got all those clean sheets, but we have had some difficulties in matches. They have been challenged at times, but you just look at the quality. I mean, he's touched on the fact that he's been blessed with the quality of players that he has in his side. You know, I mentioned Mehdi Khalil at the back, Khalil Khamis, who unfortunately misses out with a little bit of an injury. He is on the bench, misses out on the starting lineup for Al Ahed, though. But, you know, he's been the mainstay in that defence alongside Mehdi Khalil. The both of them, up until this point, played in every minute of Al Ahed's AFC Cup campaign. But even though he comes out, Amal Al-Saleh comes in, Syrian international, and he gives them plenty of experience in central defence. Just in terms of their structure, in terms of their plan, we've seen them at times in some matches early on this campaign play with 5-4-1, five at the back, across the back, sit quite deep, and make sure they try and close those spaces in between the lines. But in the West Zone finals, up against Al Jazeera, they went with a 4-2-3-1. And, you know, players like Mohamed Haider will be players that you have to keep a lookout for with the chances that he's created. 13 chances in 7 matches in the AFC Cup campaign for them so far. Ahmad Akeji is a powerful striker up front, very intelligent with his movement, has got lots of experience playing out here in Saudi Arabia with Al Ittihad and Al Ittifaq recently. So, you know, they've got that quality in there. Rabi Ataya, again, another one to look out for. Ahmad Zrik. So, you know, they'll try and make it compact, defend with perhaps at 6 and 7 with Faour and Yakubu in central midfield, and then perhaps let the front four do the talking.
All right, very quickly, Darushan, because we're almost running out of time, but you know, you've played at very in the Champions League before, the AFC Cup. What are the nerves maybe that these players are going through tonight?
Look, these guys are seasoned, international seasoned players, and there will be nerves, you know, and different players deal with those nerves differently. It affects some a lot more than others. I know the temptation for a lot of people, a lot of pundits, is to stand up here and say, nah, you know, never felt nervous, but no, it's quite natural to be nervous. It's quite normal, but they've also got that ability to overcome that, and that's absolutely what we're going to see from these two sides tonight.
Awesome, Roshan. And with that, we will be back later on in the halftime show, but for now, enjoy the game. The kickoff is happening really soon, and see you at the halftime show.